Welcome to Online ETs 2020, Lesson 4, Be a Good Child on Saturday 20th of June at 2 p.m.
It's Father's Day! What should we do?
我们要做什么呢?
I have an idea! Let's check out ETs!
Hi children! Uncle Yap and Auntie Chilling again. Are you looking for great ideas for Father's Day? You came to the right place. Before we start our E-Kids lesson today with a prayer by Auntie Chilling, I want you to know one thing. Many of us have fathers that love us very much. But some of us don't have our fathers with us, or we may not feel that they love us. However, remember this. We have God, our Father in heaven, and He loves us. How do we know? Because Jesus told us so in the Bible. Jesus asks us to call God our Abba Father. Jesus said, our Abba Father in heaven loves us very, very much.
小朋友们，那我们一起来做个祷告。亲爱的天父，感谢你告诉我们，如果我们接受、相信你，我们就可以成为神你的儿女。 我们也能称你为我们的阿爸天父，帮助我们今天在E-Kids的课程里更加明白天父你对我们的爱，同时也学习如何做个顺服听话、让父母亲高兴的好孩子。我们祷告，奉耶稣的名，阿门。
Hello children, how are you today? Today I will teach you the song, let us sing and dance a song. It's a very old song, but I hope you all can remember, okay? You still remember the song, the Ten Commandments? Yes? No? Yes? Okay, so let us sing this song, like follow me step by step, okay? You still remember this one? What's the first commandment? God first. Second one, no idol. Third one, don't misuse God's name. Fourth, number four, worship and rest. Number five, honor your parents. Number six, no murder. Number seven, no adultery. Number eight, don't steal. Number nine, don't lie. Number 10, don't covet. Okay, so let's sing this song with me. Okay. Are you ready? Okay, let's sing this song. Okay, you still remember from 1 to 10?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The 10 commandments.
Again,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the 10 commandments. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the 10 commandments. And then you'll discover how to love and treat each other when you keep the 10 commandments.
Keep the 10 commandments.
When you keep the 10 commandments. Okay? You keep the 10 commandments, okay? Very good. Well done, well done.
Okay, this song is more challenging, but I know you can do it. So hit the floor and get your space. Let's dance and sing with me. All right?
Thank you.
for joining me, Sister Lindsay. Thank you for dancing and singing along with me. So let we commit this time to the Lord and thank you and thank Him for His goodness in our lives. Amen. Let's pray. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for the time that we can praise and worship you, O Lord Jesus. I pray that you continue to protect us, and we love you. We love you deep down in our hearts. And thank you, Jesus, again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Lily.
Papa, can you read me a story, please?
Can!
Yay!
Okay, Lily, you sit here. Xavier, sit there. Why don't hit it all? Alright. So, okay, let's read today's story, the Jesus Storybook Bible. Okay? And let's see which book, which story you read today. Okay, let's read this one. Running Away, the story of the lost son from Luke 15. Okay? Jesus told this story about a boy who ran away. Once upon a time, there was a boy and his dad. Now, one day, the boy gets to thinking, maybe if I didn't have my dad around telling me what is good for me all the time, I'll be happier. He's spoiling my fun, he thinks. Does my dad really want me to be happy? Does my dad really love me? The son never thought of that before. But suddenly he doesn't know anymore. So the son goes to his father and says, Dad, I'm better off without you. I can look after myself. Just give me my share of your money. His father is sad, but he won't force his boy to stay. So he gives his son what he wants.
Papa loves the boy so much.
The son takes the money and goes on a long, long journey to a far-off country. And everything's wonderful and perfect for a while. He can go wherever he wants, do whatever he wants, be whoever he wants. He is the boss. He is free. Sometimes he gets a strange, hungry, homesick feeling inside his heart. But then he just eats more, or drinks more, or buys more clothes, or goes to more parties until it goes away. But soon his money runs out, and so do his friends. He ends up getting the only job he can find, feeding pigs. Yuck. One day, he is so hungry and so desperate, he even tries some piggy food. What am I doing? He says suddenly, as if he has woken from a nightmare. He spits, yuck, all of it, eek, out of his mouth. My father is rich, and here I am in a pigsty, eating piggy food. He wipes his mouth and dusts himself off. I'm going home. As he starts for home, though, he begins to worry. You want to read this, Xavier?
Dad won't love me anymore. I've been too bad. He won't want me for his son anymore.
So he practices his I'm sorry speech. All this time, what he doesn't know is that day after day, his dad has been standing on his porch, straining his eyes, looking into the distance, waiting for his son to come home. He just can't stop loving him. He longs for the sound of his boy's voice. He can't be happy until he gets him back. The son is still a long way off, but his dad sees him coming. What will the dad do? Fold his arms and frown? Shout, "Dad will teach you!" And, "Just you wait, young man!" No. That's not how this story goes. The dad leaps off the porch, races down the hill, through the gap in the hedge, up the road. But before his son can even begin his I'm sorry speech, his dad runs to him, throws his arms around him, and can't stop kissing him. Let's have a party, his dad shouts. My boy's home. He ran away. I lost him. But now I have him back. Jesus told them, God is like the dad who couldn't stop loving his boy. And people are like the son who said, does my dad really want me to be happy? Jesus told people this story to show them what God is like and to show people what they are like so they could know. However far they ran, however well they hid, however lost they were, it wouldn't matter because God's children could never run too far or be too lost for God to find them. See, this is a very good story, huh? Of God being a good father. And then we also need to be, Papa also need to be a good papa. Papa learn also from here.
Papa, what if there is no papa? Or the papa doesn't love the child?
Hello children, this is Uncle Terence. And Uncle Terence wants to share with you today some important truths. Every child, when they are born, they are brought to life by a father and a mother. And when the child is born, the papa and mama take care of the baby. They take care of the baby, they go and feed the baby, they go and bonbon, clean the baby, and they go and help the baby go to sleep. So that's what the papa and mama do. So in this world, every father is supposed to love every child. Okay? So this is a truth. And in every family, as the baby grows up, so the baby don't know how to walk, and then slowly he know how to stand, then know how to walk, how to run, how to jump. Then the papa and the mama is teaching the child, the baby, to walk, to stand, to run, to jump. Okay, that's what the papa and mama do. And the papa also will teach the children what is right and what is wrong. Okay, so that is where the papa will discipline. Oh, I know that children don't like to be disciplined, don't like to be punished, but the reason why is to know what is right and what is wrong. But every father loves to be with you. Okay, even as they're disciplined, they love to be with you. They want to see you grow up to be a good person. Okay, that is why papas teach you what is right and what is wrong. And as the children grow up, and you are in baby, then you can walk, then you go to primary school, then from primary school, you become older, and then you go to secondary school. And then after that, slowly you grow up to be not a young boy, a young girl, but you grow up to be a young man and a young woman. Okay? And that is what Papa and Mama want to see. They become a young man and young woman that can take care of yourself. Okay? So that is something that is very important to your Papa and Mama. And this is another important truth. A family is to love one another. The papa and the mama love each other. The papa, mama, and the children also love each other. Okay, so that is an important truth. And then everybody love one another. Okay, but it doesn't happen when we don't love one another as we should. The papa and mama, sometimes, for some families, they don't stay together. And the father and mother and the children, sometimes, for some family, they are also not able to love one another. And this is very sad. And this happens. Okay? And the reason why is because in us there is brokenness. We are all broken. Okay? Everybody is broken. There is something in us that makes us not able to love each other the way we are supposed to be. And what happens is that we hurt one another. Instead of loving, we hurt one another. Okay, this is for the older and also for the younger. Okay? And Christians call what makes us broken sin. So sin is in us, and that sin is the reason why we hurt one another. And sin is the one that put us far away from God. So God was with us in the beginning, but because of sin, we are away from God. And because we are away from God, that is why we cannot love our family the way we should. Okay? So it's because of sin. But there is a good news. And the good news is this. Jesus took all our sins. Jesus took the sins of the world. Okay? All the sins from past, last time, thousands of years ago, to now, to the future, 10, 100, thousands of years later, Jesus took all, everybody's sin in Malaysia, in America, in Australia, in Africa, in China, Taiwan, everywhere. Jesus took everybody's sin. Okay? And our sins died on the cross with Him. So our sins, your sins and mine, are on the cross, and Jesus died, and our sins died with Him. And this means that everybody who believes in Jesus are forgiven. And because we are forgiven, we forgive each other. So when you hurt me, when you step on my toe, and I'm very hurt, I can forgive you because I was forgiven by God for my own wrong. So when I break your heart, then you also have the power, because God gave you the power to forgive me. And we can forgive one another. And loved, because we are loved by God, because God's love is pure, is good, is perfect. God's love is perfect. So when we are loved by God, we know that this is true love. A love that, like the story I just told you, okay? The son, no matter how bad is the son, the papa still loves the son. As long as the son comes back to the papa. Okay? So that is God's love. God's love doesn't have any evil inside. And because we are loved by this great love, we also can love each other. And then we can build a family that loves one another. So that is what I want to tell you, this important truth. We are supposed to love one another, okay? We are supposed to love one another. But because of sin, we cannot. There is a distance between everybody. And we hurt each other. We are broken. But the good news is this, that Jesus died for our sins, and we can now love each other the way God wants us to love one another. Okay? So this is important. And I want to tell you a story. And there was a boy, okay, who didn't get along with his father. The boy grew up angry and bitter. Okay? So this is a sad story. Okay? The boy and the father, the boy didn't get a lot of love from the father. But what happened was, and we hear this true story, he found God. And God changed the boy's heart. God fixed the broken heart. God showed the love of God to this boy who is now a young man, and then helped the young man to see about his own papa, mama, about his family, about hope, that there is a day that you have good things from God. Okay? So that is hope, that no matter where we are now, no matter how things are right now, in God, we have hope. And because God is the good, good Father, we know that our life, if it is in God, will have a happy ending. If we have faith in Jesus, we will always have happily ever after. That's how our story will always end. Okay? Because God is the good, good Father. And this young boy, it's a true story, this young boy became a man. And the man became a husband. He found a person to love. and the woman also found a man to love. And they got two children. And the boy became a man, the man became a husband and a father. And not only that, because God's love is in him, he now can love more people and he can be like a father to many young people. Okay, so he is for many young people, they are welcome to his house. They sit with him, they laugh, they joke, they sing, they dance. So he was free. Remember the story? Last time he was very angry. Okay, but today he is free. So he is able to have young people in the house and they can have fun together. Okay, and that is my friend in church. Okay, he's one of the church uncle. His name is Uncle Franco. And because in God, you see, okay, this is what I want to teach you. In God, little boys have hope, and little girls also have hope. Okay, and in God, all fathers have hope to be a better father, to be a more loving father, to be a father who is kind and tender to his children. And same also with mothers. Okay? Mothers, in God, all mothers have hope also to be a better mother, a loving, kind and tender mother. Because God loves us so much. It's not because the church is a better father and mother. No. It's not. You have your parents, you have people who are looking after you. But we are saying here is that the love of God fills our heart and then we share this love with the people around us. And the brokenness that is in our lives, that is in everybody's life, is fixed because God fixes broken hearts. Say with me, God fixes broken hearts. Okay? Because He is the good, good Father. Do you remember all the stories you heard in E-Kids? Uncle Terence and Auntie Joanne, we tell you stories. Okay, so we like to tell you stories. And one of the stories today we learn, Uncle Terence teach you today, is about the son who left the father. Remember or not? And then the son say, "I want money." And then in the end, the father give the money, but the son wastes everything and he got nothing left and he's eating pig food. Do you want to eat pig food? No, right? So the son said, "Oh no, what have I done? I have done something very wrong. I need to go back to the father and ask for forgiveness. Say, I'm sorry, please, I'm so sorry." And then when he come back, he thought the father is going to be angry, but God the Father ran at him, hug him and say, "My son has come back. My son was lost, but now is found." And the story, remember children, what is the strong truth of this story? God's children could never run too far or be too lost for God to find them. Okay? No matter how bad you are, no matter how old you become, even if you're a very old man, you're 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 years old, and you have not loved God for 100 years already. But even at that time, if you come back, and I pray that you will go to God, God the Father will hug you and kiss you and love you and will fill your heart with joy and happiness. So don't wait until you're 100 years old. Pray to God today. Let God fill you with this joy today. Okay? Do you remember all the crafts you made in E-Kids? We remember all the uncle, auntie, Coco and Titi, they're helping you cut, glue, color, draw. Now we cannot because of this virus. But children, I want to encourage you. The teachers are still very excited when you do crafts at home. Okay? And please continue to send your photos. Uncle see these photos. Uncle miss you all very much. So do the other teachers and the Coco and the Titie. Okay? So send your photos. Send your videos. And then we remember you and we pray for you, okay? And we are also hoping that one day we will see each other again. That is our hope, okay? That what we are doing now is only for a while. So be patient. This is only for a while. But one day, we will return, and then we'll see each other again, and then we can have fun. We can have games! Do you remember all the games you play in E-Kids? Huh? Everybody laughing. And then, remember not, you have to listen to instructions. That is what Uncle Yap always say, right? Children, children, you didn't listen to instruction because you are always talking. Because you're always talking, we cannot play the game properly. Then you listen and then you can play the game. Remember that? So if you listen to the game, what is how to play the game, then you can have fun. But if you don't listen, you want to do your own thing, then we cannot play the game and we cannot have fun. Okay, it's also the same. God has also given us ways to live life. Okay, He has also given us ways to live life so that we can be filled. This, the same way that you know when you remember you eat all the food in E-Kids, you're filled and your stomach is happy. Yeah? And then you drink and then your stomach is happy. Yes? So in the same way, when we listen to God's instruction, our heart is also filled. Okay? If we don't listen to what is the right way to live, okay, how to love one another, how to love God, what happens is we become hungry, and when we're hungry, we become angry. Because we don't get fed. Now, how do we get fed? We get fed by listening and doing what God says. Okay? So that is how we become full in the Spirit. That we hear God's word. God says what? God says that we are supposed to love our parents. Another one, this one. Do you remember all the smiles you gave in E-Kids? Okay? So, we also remember you and we want to celebrate. So, we want to see you grow up. So, you have your family at home, the people who are looking after you, and there can be many people looking after you, more people. You can have your akong, you can have your nainai, waikong, waipo, you can have your auntie, kuku, and you have susu, or whoever, you have more people in your family, and they are loving you, okay? So, and then you have to love them, respect them, and honor them. And not only that, you also have the church, and the church also see you grow up. When you were a little boy in primary one, then slowly, wow, you're so tall already, primary six. So, I want you to remember all the smiles you also gave in E-Kids. So, you already have many things to remember, right? You have the stories, you have the crafts, you have the games, you have the food, you have the smiles. But there is one thing that's very important for you to remember. Do you remember or not? Do you remember all of the Ten Commandments? Huh? This is something you've been teaching, right? So we have the song. Do you remember the song? So first one is what? What's the first one? Ah, correct. God first. You can sing the song in your head already, right? God first. No idols. Don't misuse God's name. Worship and rest. And what's the last one? Honor your parents. Okay? And then number 6 to 10 is what? Number 6 is no murder. No adultery. Don't steal, don't lie, and don't covet. So this is the Ten Commandments. So, like I said just now, this is God's instruction. And God gives us this, and then we hear this, and then we do it, and then we get filled, okay? We become happy. We become happy when we do what God tells us to do. Because what God tells us to do is good. Just like playing games, okay? Just like playing games. So, what is the fifth commandment? What is the fifth commandment? Yes, that is correct. The fifth commandment is honor your parents. Honor the ones looking after you, okay? So, honor the people looking after you. And then we, in the uncles and aunties, see you grow up. Your family also see you grow up. And you know what? You know what this means or not? Do you know what this means? It means you have a lot of people loving you. It means that you are very, very blessed. It means that you have many things to thank God for. And one of them is to thank God for your papa and for your mama. Okay? So, be happy. And the reason why we honor your parents and honor the ones looking after you is because God commanded it. And He is good. Okay? So if you do what God says, your life will be good. And even though it's difficult, because I know sometimes it's hard to do what is right. It's hard to be a good boy, to be a good girl. But there is a way. Okay? There is a way. But I want you all to remember, you honor your parents because God says you are to do so. It's very important. It's in His Ten Commandments, He said. Say you cannot murder, cannot steal, cannot lie. One of the things is, honor your parents. Okay? And together, okay? Together, the families and the church here that loves you, we help you to do this. So that you can say, okay? Read together. I will honor my parents every day. I will love my parents every day. Very good. And then, yes, I can. Another one. Yes, I will. Very good. And the reason why you can do it, okay, the reason why you can do it is because you have God's strength in you. You ask God, you pray to God, God help me to be a good boy, a good girl. And because God is able to help you, okay, to help me do it. I want us to remember this. Because sometimes you still do wrong. And then when you do wrong, the most important thing is you know how to ask for forgiveness. And because God forgive you, you can go to your papa, you go to your mama. Papa, I'm sorry. I didn't wash the plate. Mama, I'm sorry. I disturbed sister. So you can do it because you know how God loves you so much. How your parents love you so much. Okay? So this is something important. So remember children. Okay? You remember children. You can remember stories, games, crafts, food. But important, you remember the Ten Commandments, and you also remember this. Okay, don't forget. You have a family who loves you. You have a church who loves you. And most important, you have God the Father who loves you. I want you to remember this truth. Okay, and we would look forward. We want to see you guys again. That's our hope. So before we end today, let us do this memory verse. Okay, Uncle will read one time first, and then slowly Uncle will take out the words So slowly Baba Uncle take out the words, and then we remember it. Okay, let's see whether you can do it. Uncle know you can do it. You're very smart. Okay, Uncle Yao Zhong tell Uncle that the children are very good. They can do this thing very well. And Uncle Terence knows it. I've seen it before. So let's do it. A father is tender and kind to his children. In the same way, the Lord is tender and kind to those who have respect for Him. Psalm 103, verse 13. Let's try again. Now this time, remove the words. Remove the red words, okay? Remove the red words. A father is tender and kind to his children. In the same way, the Lord is tender and kind to those who have respect for Him. Very good. Next. A father is tender and kind to his... What is it? Children, in the same way, the Lord is tender and kind to those who have what? respect to those who have respect for him. Psalm 103, verse 13. Okay, next, getting harder, but I think you can do it. A father is tender and kind to his children. In the same way, the Lord is tender and kind to those who have respect for him. Psalm 103, verse 13. Now is the scary part. A father is tender and kind to his children. In the same way, the Lord is tender and kind to those who have respect for him. Psalm 103, verse 13. Well done. Okay? Well done. Remember this. Okay? Remember this. And remember to pray to God for your papa, for your mama, for those who are looking after you. Come, let's do a short prayer before you go to the next class. Okay? Let's do a short one. Close your eyes, put your hands together, and pray together with Uncle. Dear God, thank you for my papa, for my mama, for those who look after me, my family. Lord, please love them and love me. And Lord, I pray that we will have a good Father's Day and we will remember your love. We will remember that you are a good, good Father. And no matter how far we go away from you, we know, everyone will know, that we can always come back to your love. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right then. So have fun in the next class, lah. Until next week, Uncle Terence say bye-bye. God bless.
Hi, children. How are y'all? I hope y'all are doing well. Welcome back to eKids Craft. Today is Auntie Yinling again with y'all. Are you ready to do some craft work? Good. Okay. Do you know what are we going to do today? Well, it has to do with tomorrow, right? Because tomorrow is a special day. Do you know what is it? I think I heard something louder. Yes, you are right. Tomorrow is Father's Day. Of course, we must make something for our father. Today, we are going to make a Father's Day card. It is a special card because it is in the shape of heart. Here it is. We're going to make this card. So you can see it's a heart shape. And there's a shirt inside with a tie, a red tie. And there's a blue coat. The coat has two buttons. And there's also an award ribbon here that says number one dad. Okay. And now we're going to open up to see how does inside look. When you open up, it actually looks like a flower. It's actually formed by four heart shapes. Inside, you will write, Happy Father's Day. You are awesome. And love, your name, or you can write son or daughter. And there are a lot of white spaces around here. What I've done is, I have write some words that describe my father. So you can choose some words to describe your daddy, or you can also draw some pictures about things that your daddy likes. Okay, let's close it up. So Let's turn it around and see what's at the back. So at the back of the card, you're going to write the memory verse that you learned in your story time today. Okay? So that you will share this memory verse with your daddy when you give him this Father's Day card. All right? Shall we get started? Good. Okay, before we start doing our craft, we're going to get ready the things we need. So today we'll need a pair of scissors, glue, marker pen, some pens, pencil, a ruler, and we will need some A4 paper, a white one, and two colorful A4 paper. Yep, that'll be all. So gather all the things you need and come back and we're gonna start. So for the first step, we're gonna start with the white A4 paper. Okay, so there's a short end and the other side is the long end, right? Okay, what I want you to do is take this corner and then fold it down where the short end will be aligned with the long end. Okay, let's do it. Try to make it touch just nice on the long end. Okay, so you should get something like this. So just now the A4 paper is like this. So we take this corner and put it down and fold it. Okay, now I want you to cut here. Okay, so that we only have a piece of square paper. So take your scissors and cut it up. So after you cut it out, you have a one small piece of paper. Put it aside, we'll use that later. And then if you open back this paper, you will get a square paper. Got it? Okay. Okay, now I want you to fold. Okay, now the square paper, we have a line like this, right? Yeah, that's what we folded just now. I want you to fold it down this way now, to this way. So fold it down. Okay, so fold it like this. And so that when you open up, your square will have two lines now. Okay? Right, next thing I want you to do is turn the paper the other way and fold it into half. Fold the paper into half like this. Okay? I'm going to add more lines to the square. Okay? So now, just now we have a cross on it. Then we fold into half, we get another horizontal line. Now we're going to fold it the other side half so that we get a vertical line. So fold it. Vertically into half. So when you open up your paper, so you should have a vertical line, a horizontal line, and two cross lines. Got it?
So children, this is what we have just folded. Okay? So what I want you to do is, I want you to fold this line inside. Push this up. And go, let it go in. Okay? And do the same for the other side. This line also go inside. Like this. Okay? So lift them up. You should get like this from the top view. If you open up, you should get something like this. If you put it down, it should be in the shape of a triangle. Got it? Okay, let me show you again. So just now we have folded like this, right? Okay, put your paper in this way. And for this line, we would like to fold it up. Okay, so you push it, lift it up, and fold on this line. Okay, do the same for this side. Push it up and lift it. And then close it up. Okay, and then if you lie it down, it will be in a triangle shape. Got it? So you can see we can open this up like this on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Fold it down to make a smaller triangle. Okay? So this is the side that you can open up. This is the side that cannot be opened. Alright, now we're going to draw a half heart shape here. Then we're going to cut it out. So let's draw here. Yeah, briefly that will look like a heart shape. Then take your scissors and cut it out. Okay. Now we're going to open it up. See, it's the heart shape. So if you open up the paper, it'll look like a flower formed by four hearts. Got it? Good. Okay, now close it back the same way. Fold this up, these two sides, remember? These two sides. Lift it up. And close the other two. Okay, so this is the heart shape we have. Okay, put it aside for a while. Now take your one of the color paper, the paper that you want to make the code. Okay. Fold it into half on the short side. You see? Okay. Fold it into half on the short side. Okay. Next. So this is how it is. Here's the connector part. Now put your heart at this corner. So this side, we can open. Okay, put your heart at this corner and trace the heart. Trace it on the blue paper. Okay, got it? Now let's cut it out. Follow the line you trace. Let's try your best to cut according to the line. Okay. And if you open up, you actually have two hearts. Right? Now cut in the middle line here. So these two hearts will then be used for the front and the back of your card. Okay? Okay, let's put this aside. Now let's make some of the buttons and also the award ribbon. So take back the small piece of the white paper that we cut out just now, and I'm going to trace the marker pen. This will be used for the award ribbon. Okay. Then I will take a pen cover to trace to make the buttons. We need two buttons. So add four dots on the buttons. Another four on the other button. And write number one dot for the award ribbon. And O with a dot. And write a one, and that is D, A, D. Now we will cut them out. Can you see? This is how it looks like. Now we will cut them out. Okay, here we are. Okay, now take the red paper or another color paper you have. Now we're going to do the tie. So you draw a straight line. Okay. Then you draw another straight line. Then you draw it across. So we draw it making a square. Then from the bottom of the square, go in a bit. We draw a line out. Then on same on the other side, at the opposite direction. Make it longer a bit. Okay. Then maybe around the middle here, we will join it up to make a tie. Okay, so this is the tie. Then for the reward button, we will need to cut these two ribbon up. So just draw straight line, another straight line. Okay, then just do a V shape like that. Okay, we're done. Let's cut it out. Tie is done. So we're done. And now take one of the blue heart and I want you to draw a line, but not a full line, maybe until around here, almost half of it. Okay, then cut it. Then we're gonna fold it. Okay, let's turn to the other side so that we don't see the paper line, or we can erase some of this paper mark as well. Pencil mark. Sorry, I mean pencil mark. Okay, turn it around. And then you should put a ruler here. Okay, then we would like to fold it out so that is the coat, the collar of the coat. Do the same for the other side. Fold it to become the collar of the coat. Okay, there you go. This is done. Now take your white heart. We're going to make a little small cut here and do the shirt collar. This one, just a small one will do. Okay. And just cut one piece of it. And then fold it down. Fold it down. Father's Day card. Okay, so now we're going to make the front cover. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to stick the tie on the shirt. Okay, get your glue. And stick it on the shirt. Put it in the middle of the shirt. Like this. Okay, put it under the collar. Should be under the collar. Then we fold the collar down and cover part of the tie. Next, we will stick the coat, okay, to cover up the shirt. Alright, stick like this. Already, so make sure it's aligned with the heart shape. Of the shirt and press it down. Should get something like this. Got it? Okay, next, we're going to add the two buttons. So put two buttons here, one here, and another one here for the coat. Take your button, put some glue, and stick it on. You should get this. Got it? Okay, next, we're gonna stick the award ribbon on this side. Okay, we're gonna stick the ribbon part first. So take the ribbon. Put some glue on it. And stick it. Take another ribbon. Put some glue on it. And stick them side by side, but only touch on the top. Like this. Okay, and I choose to put the glue only on the top part. The bottom part, there's no glue, so it's like open up a bit. Okay. Okay, now take the top part of the award ribbon, the one with the number one there. Put some glue on it. And stick it. You can cover a little bit of the red ribbon part. Here it is. Just to make sure your collar will not cover the award ribbon so that we can still see it. Okay? So we have just completed the front page of the card. Now I want you to open it up. So open it up. You look like a flower. Okay. Now I want you to take back the red color paper. Alright. And I want you to put it at this tip here for this end. Push it near until it touch. Okay. And then make sure it's aligned until the other end here where there's a curved part. Okay, there's a tip. Take a pencil and make a mark here. Alright, make a mark. Okay, now we're going to fold it. Okay, fold on this mark and try to fold a straight line for it. So how do you know if you, when you fold, it'll be a straight line or not? So turn it around. So you can see the mark is here. Okay, so press on the mark. And then this line should be aligned with this. It should be straight together. Okay, it's aligned now. Then I will press it down. Okay, so we have a straight line now. Okay, now what I want you to do is you take this end and you fold it to be aligned with this line that we just folded. Okay, so cut along with this line to get the square. We're going to cut it out, then we will have a red square. Okay, now we can open it up, then cut along this line. So we have just made a red square. Okay, now let's write on the card. Happy Father's Day. And then you are awesome. Love. You can write your name or you can write you're the son or the daughter. And if you want, you can decorate around as well. Okay, draw something that you or your daddy like. So the next thing you do is take what you've written, okay, and stick it on the flower paper. Okay? So this is how it will look like after you stick it. Might have a bit of stain here, but that's fine. Okay. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to write words that describe your father. So here, I prepare a list of words that you can choose from. Okay, if not, if you think of any words that you think is more suitable to describe your father, okay, you can also put it into the card. All right. So, for example, I think my daddy is brave. My daddy is strong. My daddy is loving. He is an honest person. He is kind. He is patient. He is cheerful. And maybe he is smart. Okay, so choose the words you want that is best to describe your father. Okay, now we have to close back the card. Okay, so before that, what we have to do is we have to fold the paper. Okay. So let's do it this way. Let's fold it this way. Fold it into half like this. Okay. And fold it in across. And fold it in across this way. Because the red paper was not with lines. Now we can close it back. So remember, these two parts have to come up. Okay, and then you close it. Okay, so we're done with the cover. We're done with the inside. Now we will do the last part. The back of it. So this is the last part that we're gonna write and stick it on. Stick on the back of it.
We're gonna write your memory verse.
So let's start. A father is tender and kind to his children. Period. In the same way, comma, the Lord, which refers to God, is tender and kind to those who have respect for him. And this is from Psalm 103:13. Okay, so bring back your heart. So just now we already close it down. Okay, turn it the other side. Okay, now I'm going to stick this on. Then we will be finished. Okay, let's put some glue on. Oops, sticky. Stick it on, follow the heart shape. And then press it. So children, I hope you have fun making this Father's Day card. You can also make this card to give it to your grandpa, your gong gong, or your ye ye also. I bet they would love to receive a card from you. So hope you enjoy this. And also remember, after you make the card, take a photo with the card and send it to us so that we can see your creation as well. All right? Bye. I'll see you next time.
Hi, children. It's Father's Day. Okay, let me tell you something. Here are three important things that you can do for or with your father. So, let's learn it together and then promise me that you will do it every day, okay? So, let's go! Greet your daddy.
Hi, daddy. How is your day?
Daddy's pretty tired today, sweetheart. It's been a busy day.
Oh, really? Okay, then. Let me help you carry your briefcase, Daddy.
That's so sweet of you. Thanks, sweetheart.
You're most welcome, Daddy.
Play with Daddy.
Daddy, Daddy, let's play with me.
Okay. What game do we play today?
How about hide and seek?
Okay, that sounds fun. Let's play.
Okay, I will close my eyes and count to 50. While you get to your hiding place, okay?
Okay.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
A few moments later.
And 50. I'm coming for ya. Now it's my turn to go hide, Daddy.
Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3.
A few moments later.
And 50. I'm coming for ya.
Thank you for playing with me, Daddy.
Oh, you're welcome, precious one.
Pray for your daddy.
Daddy, Daddy, can I pray for you?
Yes, of course, sweetheart.
What can I pray for you, Daddy?
Maybe you can pray for Daddy's back pain, because Daddy feels uncomfortable sometimes because of it.
Okay, Daddy, let us pray. Dear Father in heaven, please take away my daddy's back pain so that he will feel more comfortable again. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart.
Love you 3,000, Daddy.
I love you more, sweetheart.
Bless my daddy. Protect him when he is working. I pray that he will fulfill your will and your purpose in his life.
I pray that he may grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们祷告，向天父上帝祷告，爸爸可以有一个健康的身体，然后我们也祷告，爸爸可以有聪明智慧解决工作上的问题。我们也向天父祷告，让爸爸可以更加认识上帝，让他有满满的福气。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Okay, see you children. See you next week.
Bye.